Hi, welcome to SBR Videos. I'm Peter Lozak. This is our daily pitching matchups preview show that we do with Joe Duffy from OffshoreInsiders.com. Right now, we're looking at the matchups for Thursday, April 29th. Joe Duffy, thanks for being back with us.
Thank you for having me, Peter.
Sorry, that's Thursday, April 30th. Joe Duffy, tell us how things are going at OffshoreInsiders.com before we look at this short card today.
Pretty darn good. As we file this, as we're doing this video, 90 and 81 with 78 underdog winners, 26 of them of $1.30 or more. So it's just another typical year for Joe Duffy's picks. And we've been doing this since the Score Phone days. We've made some adjustments over the years, but same results.
All right, Joe. Well, the Thursday card, there's only eight games. Let's start out with one of the minor matchups here. The White Sox at Minnesota. Trevor May is starting, and he took a line drive off of his right forearm in his last start. You know, at maximum health, he wasn't that great to begin with anyway. Chicago does have a pretty live lineup in general. Do you think Trevor May might get crushed here at home against the White Sox?
Probably a good matchup for the White Sox. When I looked at the Thursday portfolio, nothing completely jumped out at me at that game. You know, you're going to have a pretty high total, but would seem to be advantageous for the White Sox bats for sure.
All right, and then we have Washington at the Mets. Strasburg going again. He tends to be overvalued. If he had seven innings, a shutout ball or one run, that wouldn't be a shock to anyone. The Mets, I think, are overvalued because of their start, but DeGrom is legitimately awesome. So I'm thinking, you know, this might be a spot where we get DeGrom at a very reduced price, and maybe the Mets might be a good bet here. What do you think?
I'd be a little bit worried about DeGrom and kind of the famous bubble burst theory. He gave up three homers and six runs in five innings against the Yankees. So now he's, you know, returning home after he was pitching so extremely well. And we're talking about a guy who, not saying that DeGrom's not for real, but you're talking about a guy who's pitching out of his skull and now is coming off of a bad outing, and he's got a tough pitching matchup here. I say it just about any time we talk about the Washington Nationals. It's tough to get good value there, but I think this is really a good spot. I look for DeGrom maybe to have a little bit of a letdown after a rough outing against the crosstown rivals.
And then Homer Bailey against Shelby Miller, Atlanta at Cincinnati. At first glance, this looks like a pitching edge to Atlanta, with Miller having a great start, Homer Bailey a little bit shaky, but I'm not sure about that. Miller's strikeout and walk numbers are okay, but not great. Bailey probably will get a bit better as the season wears on. I'm thinking that maybe this one might be the starting pitching matchup might be more equal than people are going to give it credit for. Maybe Cincinnati might actually be a decent bet here. What do you think?
Whether it's real or whether it gets back to the 90% of the game is half mental type thing, Shelby Miller started throwing a sinker in the middle of last year, and it really started doing extremely well. He's quietly going back to last year in his last 11 starts. He's got a 2.02 ERA, and since it's split over 2 years, it's kind of sneaking under the radar. It's really tough to go against Miller the way he's been pitching over, you know, since the second half of last year. And again, you know, the Braves, we're not talking about the Braves team of old, so you're getting pretty good value. I can't really go against Shelby Miller at this point.
Yeah, I hear you, Joe Duffy. Maybe the under on that one. We might get 7.5. Much more likely we'll get 7, but maybe the under?
Homer Bailey, he did start the season on the DL, so he might still be on a little bit of a pitch count, but it should be a low-scoring game. I agree.
Well, that's all I wanted to mention. I'm going to be having my eye on maybe taking the Mets if they're a home underdog. Probably looking for the White Sox to hit Trevor May pretty hard. And, yeah, that Bailey-Miller one, it'll be interesting to see what the line is when it comes out for the game. My initial thoughts are maybe leaning towards the under. Hopefully Bailey will be decent. All right, that's all I want to mention for Thursday. Joe Duffy, what else do you want to bring up?
Well, as I always say, you're not really going to get much value in stud pitchers, but obviously Scott Kazmir, he's a stud pitching like a mega, mega stud, 0.99 ERA in four starts. Meanwhile, Seattle's James Paxton, he's been getting drilled, 6.82. As far as value, necessarily going to get value, but Paxton's been terrible, so it might be a good opportunity to continue to fade him.
Joe Duffy from OffshoreInsiders.com. Thanks so much. Talk to you again very soon.